Switzerland from 2004, right? Kamalake or Nicholas Constantine. So, what I liked about his style, Sakele, 2004, he loved painting African masks. So I invited him to come to Kasi to paint and also feel the vibe and feel the African spirit. And then we created a concept called Amaswiti, where you use a lot of colors, bright colors, to create whatever, but it has to do with that, the patterns, one. Two, also reflecting the hidden gods, you know what I mean? Ukhula kwethu thina sakhula interesting, yabo. Sakhula ngesikhathi apartheid. Yabo, nge-apartheid bekunekezakale ezinye izinto asizange sizithande. Nemi 40-60 started banging shit. Started banging schools, started banging mabus, my bottle store, you door, or that. You thought which you were owned by either of you. The apartheid government, you know?
My name is Ndumiso Nyovane. Well, they call me the legend, as you can see, salt and pepper. Always in the face. So I've been around, born and bred in Soweto, right here in the cat in Mfolo, and which is our neighbor, and which is our neighborhood with Senzo. So he's a boy that enjoyed my craft and loved my craft, and I was always in the world with him, in the world with doing different logics together. And when we meet every time, he loves snooker. A table, what do you call it, snooker, no? Yeah, he likes snooker, and whenever we meet other snooker, hey, the brother, hey. I say, no, one day it will happen, my man. And he was always pushing and having time to say, hey, King Man, make time. You're the brother from the ghetto, you need to give back, you know. So, and then, you know, we're touring, sometimes I'm in Europe, he's in Europe. So, God, with the grace of the Lord, God made us to meet. Then we started a concept called life painting with music. And in most logics, in the craft of arts, it's very rare to see a visual dude pouring his moves on the board or on the paper or on the canvas. Is it a canvas?
Yes.
Yeah. And in most cases, they love to have a peace of mind and work their shit there and their stuff and to become deep. But Senzo was like, dude, I want to do this shit while you play music. It was like, dude, really? Then he said, yeah, okay. We created the gig on the 16th of December. And it was during after the late Khodihlahla Mandela's funeral. So we said, no, let's do something to sit down and celebrate Mandela's life. And that's where we started the first painting, this one. It was here in Mfolo, and it was something else, and people watching the show, and at the same time watching this beautiful artist pouring what we're doing on stage. So after that, we sat down, we created a concept during Easter weekend. We created a concept of being Jesus crucified with his disciples. Then we had a format of opera, a drum ensemble, myself and Luiso with, well, I call it jazz with an element of gospel. Then Senzo with his visual arts, and we didn't have an MC, like MC all the time, saying, hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome Ndumiso Nyovan on stage. We said, no, it's true, it's everybody's monotonous, you know, everybody does that. We thought, like, say, let's create a storyline of what we're talking about, the crucifying of Jesus. Then we had three actresses, in fact, from Soweto Theater, who were playing that part. And then after that scene introduction, they had storyline growing to the time when Jesus was crucified on the cross. And the first move, when they analyze the show, they will talk about the formation of the whole story of Jesus. Then they cut to say, let's listen to opera. Then the opera comes. And Senzo was always sleeping on the floor during the whole intro of the show and doing his hands, starting to write on the canvas that you saw, all of them. But I think it would be nice to have the footage of those two canvases. Then we started the show, and like people watching the show, the opera, doing their thing, there's this guy sleeping there, and the canvas is still clean, you know, white, and he's playing with paint, with colors, and you know, he's very artistic. Like when he starts, you can say, hey, what is he doing? That was the formation, and from there, the actors, they continue to, with the storyline of Jesus, then we introduce the drum ensemble. Then when the drum ensemble came, then he started standing up. Then that's where he started the formation of the show through the painting. When the drum ensemble finished, we had a short break. Yeah? We took a short break. Then after the short break, it was my time introducing me with the spotlight with him on stage. And surprisingly, during the set of my set, he comes and come and rap. He's a good rapper too. He's a musician. He's got everything that guy sends on club. He came in, he coys, and surprisingly came, like we planned it, but for the people, for the audience, they don't know that. You won't say, hey, Senzo come. He just, well, while he's busy painting, he knows his past, that when is his time. Then he just leaves that stuff, comes and cuts the mics, and boy, it was like, what? And after that excitement, he leaves the mic, goes back to his canvas to go and continue with the whole show. And when the show was done, the painting was done.
But you know, if you do it, you want to paint the whole building.
Yes.
So that you can create a traffic, a tourism, and declare the space as a heritage site. So that Abanda Bapila can create business opportunities when tourists are coming.
Markets
and my charm, my craft, my accessories.
So basically to activate the economy of the area. Economy.
Sure. And turn a township into an economical powerhouse.
Yes.
I want, like we did in a shop, you know what I mean? A village on the street. Now today it's a book workshop because it's kind of like that. So these are international artists, even though Farama Photograph is from France, very prominent artist, and obviously SENZART. So when you look at, across the field there, or the parking lot there,
I feel like this is a very so kind. There's a painting,
to try graffiti. I used to go to him about 80-90s, so jam together, sketch together, and we create concepts, and then do my graffiti class. I mean, I was more into fine art, where I wanted to paint on canvases and papers.